Hey, what up, Z Clan and everybody else? How you doing? I hope you all doing good. Welcome to my Fallout 76, well, we can say discussion video where I am gonna review and my kind of feedback on the Atrium shelter, which costs 1800 atoms and some feedback. I would recommend you to wait for a discount, to be honest. And also, we're gonna take it to Vault Catwalk. Bundle or no bundle? That is confusing. I'm gonna play a small clip showing you yesterday was a bundle, today it's not a bundle. But anyway, let's stop wasting time, jump right into it. Right, so as I mentioned, we're gonna take a look at the Vault Atrium shelter, right? And we're gonna take a look at the vault catwalk, which is supposedly supposed to have been a bundle. Now I'm gonna play a clip from yesterday's video when I did the Atomic Shop review for the Tuesday's reviews that I do, so you can see the difference. Oh, look at that. Original cost, own items, subtract atoms, your cost. Cool. That means if you buy something separately, oh, those shelves are nice. Oof. This is actually pretty good. I guess I have a lot of reviews to do. Alright, so now you saw the difference. It costed 1,500. 1,500 atoms for the entire bundle, which would give us the catwalk, which would give us the floor set, which would give us the utility wall shaft, which would give us the light set. I actually like those, to be honest. I'm using it with the Brotherhood Steel Scout tower. It's actually looking really nice. Illuminated vault signs. And a potted tree. So all that was in one bundle for 1,500 atoms. Unfortunately, now according to the patch notes, that is not the case, and you will need to be buying these things individually. Individually, if you purchase all of the items, it will cost you 2,200 atoms. So that's like what, 700 atoms difference, right? Yeah, 700 atoms difference. To be honest, man, the catwalk is broken. I tried a lot of things yesterday. So, as you can see, I have a catwalk over there. I was trying to make my Hot Topic wall, which, as you can see, is not turning out to be pretty quiet as what I usually do. What I mean by that it's broken, it's that it doesn't, it connects perfectly when you do it in a straight line. But as soon as you reach this section right here, right, this section is supposed to like also connect, right? And it should. Actually, you know what? Come think of it, I just remember, I think there was a screenshot over here. Yeah, you can see on the screenshot it connects, right? So if I were to build these things, so you can find the catwalk in MISC structures, by the way. So if we go, for example, and start building, by the way, it connects to sort of short edges of your wall over here, right? So it builds, right? Then it connects. Then we got a smaller version, it connects. We got a big, even smaller version, and it connects perfectly. Then we're gonna build one more of these, right? Everything is connecting perfectly, right? Boom. Now, once you build that, it does not connect. I tried everything and it refuses to connect. Like you try to do whatever you can, but it's just not connecting. And I bought the bundle because I thought this is kind of cool. In whatever case, I still found this catwalk useful, because when I was working on my wall, I would just stand here without jumping because it's a pretty big wall, and was doing my stuff. But still, I'm not happy with my wall. There's a whole bunch of, but that's in regarding to the actual vault review. I'm not very happy with the vaults, to be honest. And that's why I would highly recommend not to buy the big one, because it's just a waste. I'll go into details a little bit more. So as you can see, it's just refusing to connect. It's broken. What else do we have here? So then we got the floors, right? Wait, did it? Let me see if I can just put a floor. Oh yeah, it doesn't work like that. It works only like this. That's another thing that I've noticed. Boom, boom, boom. So over here, come on. That's not it. I think that's one of the new ones. I don't remember having this one. Replace. Don't remember having that one. These are different. So there we go. This one right here. Let's go take a look on the picture once again. What do we have there? Alright, my bad. So these are the options that we have. Right? Boom, boom. Alright, so definitely this is not the one. This one right here. This one right here. And this one right here. So it's like it's a carpet style. Alright, cool. It's good to have for builders. This I would actually recommend. It's actually pretty good. I'm going as this because I haven't had the chance to sort of review like all other components yesterday because it was just a chaos. Alright, so the lights I'm going to show you at my Brotherhood of Steel Scout Camp. The trees, I have built them. Actually, right here. Actually, looking pretty good. And you can find those at the floor decor. If you scroll down. It definitely was floor decor. It's probably with another tree set. I think maybe with this one. No. Ah, there it is. Boom. So then we got the shelves, right? The shelves are pretty cool, to be honest. There you go. This sort of can be used as a replacement for the displays. So for example, you can put your ship over here. You can put your ship over here. You can put your stains over here. Right? Whatever you own. Plushies and whatever. So you can kind of display things as well. So it's actually really nice. A good addition. Then we got the lights. By the way, let's do the lights here. Why not? So the lights over here. In the light section, these are the two. So this is the first version and this is the second version. Boom. And I like these because they kind of give a good light as well. Oh, great. Let me get a connector over here. See, it kind of gives a decent amount of light. Not the best. I still love that ceiling fan, the spinning light that never made a return. Unfortunately, I had it on my PC, but you know, it never made a return, unfortunately, which kind of sucks. Decorative tree, light ceiling. I think I got it all, right? Atomic shot. Ah, no. these things I haven't covered yet. And I think they're part of the light section as well, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, they are. Which kind of sucks, to be honest. It's my first impression. I never looked at them. I mean, I did look at them yesterday, but it was like a blink of an eye. So, boom. You see, it doesn't give a lot of light source, and it's more of a like a navigator. But instead, now, this thing drains light budget. Which comes to my feedback on shelters. That 50 light budget, man. Well, thank God it's not scattered throughout all of your shelters. So I did check with my other shelter that we all got. And there I have light of 20 out of 50. And here I got 16 out of 50. So thank God the light budget is not connected between your other vaults. But I haven't, though, checked with the other vault, the lobby vault that we got for free. Fallout First members got for free. I thought everybody got it. But unfortunately, it seems to be not the case. We're going to quickly jump in there to see the light budget, if it's still 0 out of 50, or is it, you know, 16 or 20. All right, so light budget, boom. Yep, 0 out of 50. They did not share. What the? Exit to Appalachia. Great. Give me my world door back. I want back to my lobby. Yeah, I want to like kind of like go into and review the actual lobby for 1800. Oops, I guess I built the wrong door. Ah, there we go. That's the one we need. So the shelters are like good to have. The big shelter can definitely wait with a discount, to be honest. So here's the shelter. It's got a lot of its own light. That's cool. But if you start building things, like for example on that wall, it's not that bright, so it kind of looks dark. And I mean, the hall is big. That's cool. But like we can like place a lot of different like floor decors, right? So, but we cannot place, for example, the alien thing. So the alien thing, if you want to display your stuff, right, will need to float in order for you to build it. There you go. But if you try to build it, you can't. So that will not work. The only cool thing that I found is that you can actually build this tree. Usually this tree you can build only on the ground, but for some reason it allows it to get built here. So that's kind of cool. Statues, no problem. You can build those. Like the tank, you can build it, no problem, right? You know what? I'm not happy with all that stuff, so I'm just gonna get rid of it. A couple of hours went to a waste. So scrap all and get rid of it. Boom. So you see, as I was saying, the wall is, it's kind of dark, but you can still put your stuff over here. See? But it's still kind of dark. Oh yeah, I forgot. This is another thing that I dislike about shelters. This is like, there's no gravity here. And sometimes it makes it really hard to build stuff as well. So that's kind of sucks. I really do not like about the no gravity thing. So you see, it does look kind of like darkish. So you need light. Well, you can build those over here. That's true. And you have your own light source, but still. See, these things are sticking out. So the wall, well, in my case, the Hot Topic wall kind of like. But yeah, I'll definitely figure out something to build with the shelters, but. My other thing is, okay, cool. Since that we got covered, but what if, for example, I want to like put this thing, right? I can't. Even though there is space, I can't make it float. I can't put it like here. So, meaning I can't display this item. Speaking of displays, there are no displays. So We can't display our weapons. I was really hoping, because of all this extra budget and stuff, that when we get our power armor stands, our armor mannequins, the weapon displays that we already have, but you can't build those. So, meaning you can't kind of like show the skins, display the skins. So, it's just like, okay, it's a vault. You can build here what? Beds, rooms, whatever, and pretend that this is a real vault. Okay, if you want us to do that, why don't you give us some more access to a couple of NPCs that could actually walk around here, act as if they are actually vault dwellers, that sort of stuff. That would be cool. But I would prefer like displays and stuff. That would be definitely better. So as you can see, you can't place this one right here. You can place this, I don't know why, but you can. But I think because of the foundation thing, you can't. So you see, this thing you can like place it above, but you can't really like place it. If you wanted to have a bunker inside the vault, for instance, you can't place your train. It has to float. You can't place any of these buildings over here, which take ridiculous amount of like, well, not all of them, but most of them, they take a lot of budget. So we can't like build all of these structures outside in the Appalachia camp, right? Because we kind of, well, I kind of buy these things to have and kind of like to display stuff. I know that well, there are YouTuber camp builders who like take a specific item and try to make something unique out of it, which is actually cool. But I really hate the fact that now that we got even more budget and stuff like that, this is a big space, right? But you can't load it up with stuff like to display, right? It would be nice like to kind of like show different structures and stuff like that, what you got, kind of like as if you're an item shop collector of skins and cosmetics and stuff like that. Plus other people can visit, take a look at those skins, cosmetics, make a decision if this is something that they want to buy when it comes back with a discount or something. So yeah. Let me give you a walkthrough here of the actual shelter, but I'm pretty sure most of you have already seen those, especially on PTS. I wasn't watching the PTS videos because I wanted to kind of keep my first impression, like, get be well surprised, but this is not the case with the vault. Because I was really hoping to have the access to display weapons. Like, imagine here you would have like just picture this. You got like, I don't know, like a freaking nuclear room where you have a whole bunch of computers, something space stuff or whatever. Like a whole like center here, communication center, some like a quick like, I don't know, something over here as well, or maybe a big bar or whatever. And then you walk in here, right? And you're like, ooh, man, look at all these weapons. That is actually nice. Ooh, what is that? Ooh, I want to get that one. Ooh. You get the point, right? Or, oh, man, look at all these power armors. Ooh-hoo, whoa. Oh, what's this skin? Oh, man, I might want to get that one. That's cool. Bam, 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 bam. that sort of stuff. Actually, it's even a good idea that I'm talking about it right now for Bethesda employees, if you're listening. This is like, also consider it as free marketing for your product. Like, people are to visit the other players' like shelter, and they will take a look, and then they will see, okay, that's a cool item, man. Let's Google it. What is that? Boom, boom, boom. Looks like that, At the moment, man, to be honest, with all of my items that I got, and to make something like Hot Topic, it's very hard. And well, I'm not complaining. Just don't get me wrong. Like, even though with the prices, like the Brotherhood of Steel Scout, $30, and I was complaining like, what the hell? And I even forgot to edit my, BS. I said it in full. And it's not that, it's a great bundle. It's got a whole bunch of cool stuff. I made a review for it. The thing is, it's $10. Like Raiders and Raiders and Settlers, $20 each. It was 30 for two. And logically, Brotherhood of Steel was supposed to be also $20. I was actually expecting for the $20, not $30. And I'm not complaining because I'm like broke or I can't buy something. I'm complaining that if we don't complain about it tomorrow when an Enclave bundle comes out, for example, it's not coming out, it's gonna be $40. And then they'll think of something else and it's gonna be $50. And $30 is like half the price of a new game, like Valhalla, for instance. It costs $60 and that sort of stuff. I'm not complaining, I'm just being honest with my feedback. That's it. I mean, this is a love and hate relationship and you all know that. So you all know me. So when I'm speaking something negative, I'm actually speaking something negative and not trying to make views or whatever. Okay, I think I got a little bit off topic. But yeah, so that's the thing right here. Honestly, I would most probably recommend to wait it to come with a discount, because 1800 atoms, I mean 1800, yeah, 1800 atoms, it's a lot, but you could get a whole bunch of space. So I can't even say if it's good or not, because we had these prices, 1000 and a half, and it was to be like a bundle with like five atoms. And in equivalent to this, you get like 300 atoms on top, so it's 1800 atoms, but you get a lot of build space, so that is cool, right? But the no gravity, the no ability to make display cases, I think the less people will buy the shelter will ring the alarm bells. Oh man, they're not buying, we need those displays ASAP, let's do something about it. That's what I think. So that's why I recommend to go with a discount. Personally, myself, I'm not even gonna touch this place. I spent like an hour and a half, maybe two, trying to build something. You saw what I came up with, and it's not good. By the way, I didn't want to show you how the light looks, the ceiling light looks with my Brotherhood of Steel scout tower. Which is actually pretty good. When I showed you the review of the bundle, right, it was blank, it was just a tower. Now at least got something inside, and I still have a lot of budget left, so that's cool. That's exactly what I was aiming for, to kind of like save some budget to put some more stuff in it, and to have the ability to make reviews. All right, this is my generator room. But that's not the tower. Alright, so that's the tower over there. This is what I currently got. Right? Quick camp review. So you walk in here. This is the door. It closes and opens. By the way, if you put those things over there, it makes the badge of the Brotherhood of Steel kind of glow. So that's cool. Check this out. During the night, it looks better. But it's still, you see, kind of like gets that bluish color. It's a cool one. Found it by mistake. So that's what I got here, the first floor, like vending machines and stuff, the
Thanks.
welcoming, disease cure. Second floor, I've got my crafting things, the door to the atrium, the shelter. I might gonna do something with it, I'm not sure, we'll see. And that's pretty much it. And those are the lights. They kind of like light up this place pretty well, in my opinion. So, Z Clan and everybody else, I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, you know the drill. But do not forget to hit that like, comment down below. Please make sure not to use profanity, as those comments get triggered by YouTube. I did receive a lot of good comments, but containing a lot of F-bombs, and they were actually pretty decent comments. And I was like, man, I gave an exception like one or twice throughout the history. And I'm like, man, it's a shame that only I could read those comments. So if you got something to say, feel free to comment down below. Just don't swear, and everybody will see it. Simple as that. So positive, negative, Just don't swear, and everybody and people will be able to read your comments. If you're new and you subscribe, well, welcome to Z Clan. I'm Gamer Z Soul from Ukraine. So hi from Ukraine. Once again, I hope you found this video useful. Let's have a sort of a little discussion over there. And yeah, you all have a good morning, day, and night. Whatever you guys locate at, I'll see you on the next video. Bye.